Good to see you again, Mike. Good morning. Good morning to everyone who's joining us this morning.
All right, so Attorney De Melanta, South Premier Power Corporation officially stopped supplying Meralco yesterday with the electricity. Instead, Meralco had to source the supply from the wholesale electricity spot market, which it said charges between 7 to 9 pesos per kilowatt hour compared to SPPC's 4 pesos and 30 centavos per kilowatt hour. You cited similar figures in your statement yesterday, but in concrete terms, how will this impact the average consumers of Meralco?
Okay, since this SPPC PSA is responsible for about 12 to 13% of Meralco's supply. So of the total pie, it supplies Meralco about 12 to 13% at any given month. So what can be affected is that 13%. How Meralco responds to this will be in various ways, and that's how the impact would be affected in terms of the consumer. So one, Meralco can source from the West the entire 13%, because it's possible that it's not the entire 13% that they source from WESM. They have other suppliers from which they can increase their procurement from. So the 13 may not be 13 at the end of the day. So it could be it could be less. So if I heard the statements earlier from Meralco and saying that the WESM prices, if we substitute the WESM prices to the 4 pesos and 30 centavos, and WESM would be about 8 to 9 pesos. So that's the impact. That would translate to about 30 to 40 centavos per kilowatt hour increase. For a consumer that is consuming about 200 kilowatt hour a month in its power bill, then that translates to about 60 to 80 pesos additional per month. If this continues. So it all depends on how Meralco will recalibrate its supply mix, because that's very important. And ultimately what the price in the WESM would be during this remaining period for the billing month of November, December.
Right. So Meralco was saying that it can't say yet if there will be an increase because it will depend on the WESM prices. But isn't it a foregone conclusion that there will be an increase? It's just a matter of by how much?
I think it would be best to let Meralco handle this, because it's really their responsibility how to get us to the least cost. That's the mandate, the least cost that can be supplied to the captive customers. So if they are still, I heard the statements earlier that they are still confident that it may not translate immediately to an increase, maybe they have prepared for this, they have found ways to mitigate the impact on consumers. But if it's just a straight supply from WESM substituting for that 13%, then we should brace ourselves for an increase of about, as I mentioned earlier, 60 to 80 pesos per kilowatt hour for a 200 kilowatt hour consumer.
Now, Attorney Balan, you mentioned between 30 to 40 centavos per kilowatt hour increase that will be reflected in the bills of Meralco consumers. But NASCOR is saying that could actually go as high as 50 to 60 centavos per kilowatt hour based on their computations compared to when supposedly ERC could have granted the plea of San Miguel subsidiaries. That would have only translated to 30 centavos per kilowatt hour increase for the next 6 months. So first, the figures. You're saying it's between 30 centavos to 40 centavos per kilowatt hour. NASCOR is saying 50 centavos to 60 centavos per kilowatt hour. So which is which?
Okay. I will tread lightly here, Mike, because as we know, the case is pending before the Court of Appeals, and we do not want to interfere with how the court will appreciate the respective positions of the parties. Our counsel, the Office of the Solicitor General, yesterday already filed a motion to lift or dissolve the TRO. So we want to respect that process. But just to demonstrate, the varying figures is exactly why we said it's very hard to quantify at that point when we decided this case, how much the impact would be at that point in time. Because it really depends on, one, how Meralco will, as I mentioned earlier, will recalibrate its mix. Second, how the WESM prices will play out. Mm-hmm. At that point, when the hearings were being conducted for these cases, and at that point that we made the decision, WESM prices were projected to be high. But as we have seen over the last few over the last 2 months, particularly over the last 2 weeks, OSM prices have actually tempered down. So that's why maybe I don't know how Nasecor has computed their figures, but our figures are based on what our services, our market operation service, have monitored in the OSM over the last few weeks.
But based on the statements of Nasecor and even San Miguel, it now seems that they're blaming the ERC for this development. Your reaction to that?
Again, I will have to tread lightly because of the Court of Appeals case. But what the ERC had done, and these are public, we have statements included. We have included these statements in the orders. Our goal and what we had aimed for with those orders was precisely to protect the public from this, stood our ground in implementing the fixed price nature of the power supply agreements as agreed by the parties and as approved by the ERC earlier on.
Now, in your statement yesterday, you said it is not yet clear if SPPC served a notice of termination with Meralco or merely this is a suspension of supply as a result of the CA ruling, which is not yet final. Now, walk us through the implications of either scenarios. If this is just a suspension, will this be good for the consumers ultimately?
We have received shortly before 6 p.m. last night, the formal notice from Meralco. And there we have confirmed that what San Miguel had issued to them was a suspension notice. So, and it is pursuant to the temporary restraining order that was issued by the Court of Appeals. So in their statement, they said they're acting on the basis of the TRO that was issued to them, and they believe that they were authorized under the TRO to suspend the supply for 60 days. So it gives us hope that maybe the parties can still live through and enforce the remaining term of the power supply agreement if it's just a suspension. So hope remains.
Now, on the other hand, if this were a termination though, how would it make a difference? And walk us through the process. What should be followed if SPPC were to follow that process of termination?
Okay. In the power supply agreement, there are notice requirements for for a termination. We have also discussed this in the order that we issued. There's a 60-day notice before the termination should take effect. And there is an incident where there's ground where 6 months prior notice is actually required. So those things need to be validated by Meralco. And when Meralco files its pleading in the commission to inform us of the termination, they will also need to substantiate that they have validated that these grounds exist and that the procedures were followed.
Will the period be enough, though, for Meralco to look for other suppliers that could offer a similarly competitive price to what SPPC was offering?
That's the point for the 60-day and 6-month period under the PSA. It really is meant to give Meralco the preparation needed to find a substitute supplier. Because in power supply agreements, what the utility needs to protect the consumers from is an abrupt increase or abrupt volatility in prices. So 60 days, I think, would be enough for Meralco. In fact, they have commenced, even earlier on, as I understand it, some sort of solicitation process to find a market sounding, so to speak, to find what prices are out there available for them.
Now, if the procedure is not followed, what are the consequences, Attorney Dimalanta, if there are deviations from the terms of that which you laid out?
Okay. As a general rule, I'm not speaking about this particular PSA because we need to be guided by the Court of Appeals on what the consequences are of this action if this were a termination. But as I mentioned earlier, it's a suspension pursuant to the TRO. But as a general rule, if the procedures for termination were not followed, the conditions were not validated, then the commission can actually impose penalties and have the substitute contract be deemed as what we call ineligible contracts, meaning the charges that were contracted could not be passed on. That's purely theoretical at this point, as I mentioned earlier.
All right. Now, Attorney Dimalanta, what immediate steps can we expect from the ERC at this point on this issue and from Meralco as well?
Okay. As an immediate step, as I mentioned earlier, the OSG already filed a motion to lift the TRO. We're also waiting for Meralco, if it signs already an emergency power supply agreement, to file the same with the ERC for approval. Because anything that Meralco needs to pass on to consumers, they will need to get the clearance, the approval from the Energy Regulatory Commission. So we still have safeguards in place in the regulatory structure to make sure that what will be passed on will be reasonable and just.
All right, on that note, thank you so much for joining us this morning, Attorney Mona Lisa Dimalanta, Chairperson and CEO of the ERC.